We had a very good session, very good melanoma session this year. And it was mostly about ipilimumab, nivolumab combination, you know, anti-CTLA-4 plus anti-PD-1. And we had an update of a very important trial, which is called CheckMate 067. And we have three arms. We have ipilimumab, nivolumab, nivolumab, and ipilimumab. And this is a big randomized controlled trial. So it has already been published. We know that both nivolumab containing arms do much better than ipilimumab. And we also see that ipilimumab nivolumab is above nivolumab, slightly above, not a lot, but seem to do better. The problem is that the trial was not powered enough to compare these two arms, which are really the ones that we are interested in. What we have heard by James Larkins, our colleague, is that after now 5 years of follow-up, we still have a very stable plateau. You know, we are all looking for this so-called tail of the curve. We want it to be really flat, and it's really flattening in the three arms anyway, but it's really the above one is also the EP niveau. I mean, it's still the EP niveau. And we have now at 5 years, 52% of patients alive, which is much better than what we knew before, what we had before. But I also insist on the fact that it means that we have close to 50% of patients dead. So it's much better. It seems to be the best we can do today, sort of gold standard, I would say. But we need to do better. However, we have a strong signal of toxicity with this combination. So we have a slight improvement as compared to nivolumab. It's about 7% up. So what we really need and what we absolutely want to do for the next years, a lot of teams work on that, is to understand which biomarkers are going to help us to know who can have a good response with nivolumab or anti-PD-1 pembrolizumab and not need the combination which is very toxic. That's really our goal today. But we also heard something extremely interesting from Dirk Schadendorf, our German colleague. He was presenting a trial that was conducted by a lot of German colleagues. And this was a very interesting design on patients who were stage 4, but NED, I mean, no evidence of disease. You know, this patient who had had distant metastasis, but they were resected or they were irradiated. So no disease, no active disease visible, but we know that these patients have tumor cells somewhere and they are going to relapse. Three arms, about 50% in each arm, ipi-nivo, nivo, and follow-up, not any treatment, because this is the standard of care for this patient today. Nothing has been really, except nivolumab that very recently was authorized based on an adjuvant trial, but it's very recent. So it was considered ethical, at least some years ago, not to give anything to these patients. And now we are at 2 years, so it's quite a young trial, and also it's not so many patients, 50-something patients, but still, 70% without relapse in the Nivo EP, 40% in the Nivo, and 14% in the follow-up. So it's, I mean, it's very impressive. I think it will change our practice very soon. It needs to be confirmed, of course, but this was very interesting. And the last thing, it's also an update, but it's interesting. Georgina Long, our colleague from Australia, presented the update of a trial that she called ABC, three cohorts ABC. The first cohort is today the one that is the most convincing, with ipi-nivo for patients with brain metastasis, so difficult population of patients, although this population in the A cohort is the easy population among the brain mets, because it's no symptom, no high-dose steroid, and no previous treatment in the brain. So it's a good patient, but still very interesting, because ipi-nivo does well with slightly more than 50% of response in the brain. I mean, close to 60% after this update. So we still need to know what to do in the more severe patients that are very frequently in our clinic. And also we need to know, and it's going to be evaluated by her and by others, how to position the radiosurgery in these patients before or during the systemic treatment. So that's really, I mean, the field of melanoma today has really improved a lot, and we continue to implement and to understand what we can do with immunotherapy at earlier stage of the disease. We also had some communication that were update of the neoadjuvant setting. It's Christian Blank, mostly in the Netherlands, very active in the neoadjuvant setting. You know, the concept is to inject the immunotherapy systemically when the tumor, although it's a localized tumor, is still present before the surgery. And the data that he presents suggest that it's more effective than doing the treatment after the surgery in adjuvant setting. So it's still quite preliminary data, but the cohorts are increasing and it's still very encouraging.